industrial localization, what are the factors responsible for the localization of the iron and steel industry in the world. What we have discussed, we discussed the iron steel industries of India. Yes, please. It is coal-based, ore-based, and port-based. All the industries we discussed after India, I gave you the detail of CIS including Russia and plus Ukraine. Apart from that, we also discussed the China and Japan. China is the leading, there are the three important steel manufacturing regions, rather four. One is Manchuria, Southern Manchuria, Southern Manchuria, Northern China, and the Yangtze River, Yangtze Valley region, and the Canton region. So these are the one. And the Japan, I gave you Kanto region, Kanto, Kinki, and the Kyushu region. So it is, these are the industries we discussed. Today, let's discuss the another important country, that is USA. USA is a vast country with different type of geographical conditions. Young fold mountains, Rockies. We have the relict mountains, Appalachians, prairie grassland, coastal topography, Great Lakes, perennial rivers which supply navigation, tropical climate along the Gulf of Mexico to the temperate climate in the northern region. So this is the country of heterogeneity, physiographic heterogeneity, climatological heterogeneity, vegetational heterogeneity, and heterogeneity in terms of the mineral resources. Mineral resources spread in that vast continental country. Country is equal to the subcontinent, it is a continent connecting Atlantic to Pacific. So they have different type of mineral resources. While discussing this, I simply wanted to give you one, if I make here the number one is the lake region. Lake region means Great Lakes. Great Lakes in USA. These are the, if I construct here, this is are the five different lakes. Can you name the lakes here?
So, Huron.
This is?
Huron, H-U-R-O-N.
This is Superior Lake. This is Michigan Lake. This is Huron Lake. This is Erie Lake.
Ontario.
And this is Ontario Lake. I told you that these formations of these lakes have taken place because of the U-shaped valleys formed during the different ice ages, and the U-shaped valleys later filled with the water, they converted into the lakes. So these are the Great Lakes. So along these lakes, Ontario, then there is a Lawrence River and it leads to the coastal region. So this is the St. Lawrence River. The mouth of the river is full of the fish production because there are the banks. There are the Green Bank, Sable Bank, St. Pierre Bank. Banks are there and this river is draining huge amount of organic material. So this is good fishing ground here. But in terms of this lake, if I say USA, this is Appalachian Mountain. Appalachian. And this region, Lake Erie region, this is the region with the best quality of coal. I told you, 50% of the 50% of the global anthracite coal is found in USA. That is in this region. This is you can say coal. Coal is basically anthracite. Anthracite coal mines are basically in Pennsylvania. Name of the mines are, you know, Carbondale, Scranton, Carbondale, Scranton, Wilkes Barre is the largest mine, largest Wilkes Barre. These are the three important mines near Pittsburgh. You must be knowing the city. Pittsburgh is known as the iron and steel capital of the world. This is the coal producing region here. This coal mines, these are the coal mines here. West of Pennsylvania, west of Appalachians and very close to the Erie. This Erie is connected by the canal, local Erie canal, which provides navigational facility to transport this. And these lakes are the navigational lakes. These lakes provide the navigational facility. Navigational facility means from the Atlantic, any of the heavy, bulky raw material may be transported from here to the Atlantic region or Atlantic region to this region. So this lake region is having like Lake Erie and Lake Ontario. Between Lake Erie and Ontario, there is a waterfall. So this is the Lake Ontario and this is Lake Erie. The surplus water of Lake Erie falls here. This is Lake Erie. This is Lake Ontario. But there is a waterfall. Name of the waterfall
Niagara.
Is Niagara Fall. Niagara waterfall is there. Then how the ships can travel? How ship can navigate from this Ontario to Erie? I told you these lakes provide ideal navigational facilities. So, कैसे जाते हैं वो ship? वो ship then they have in Canada they have constructed a canal on the basis of locks. The name of the canal is Welland Canal. This is the canal, Welland Canal. Welland Canal, it's very important canal. यहाँ तो waterfall है तो इसके पहले ये canal बना दी है and with the help of this canal is like lock system. You know, there are the different lock system. If you see, say this is the South America and this is North America. Here we have the, North America, this is North America, this is South America. There is the country called Panama. Panama is the isthmus. Isthmus is a narrow strip of land connecting the two big land masses. This big land mass and this big land mass connected by a narrow strip of land. Isthmus. And there is a strait. Strait is a small narrow strip of water body which connects two big water bodies. So, Gibraltar Strait, Bosporus Strait, Dardanelles Strait, Magellan Strait. So, the narrow water strip which connect two big land masses. So, this is, that is called isthmus. This is But in Panama, the sea level in Pacific and the sea level in Atlantic, there is a huge difference. There is almost 10 to 11 meter difference in the height of the water from the sea level. Here in Atlantic, water level is 11 meter higher than the water of Pacific Ocean. It is because oceanic currents comes and piled up the water over here. This is North Equatorial Atlantic Oceanic Current. It piled up water over here, so water level is higher. Then how to make the ships move from this side to this side? We have connected a canal called Panama Canal. This canal is also working on lock system. Let me repeat just quickly. I wanted to let you know what is lock system. In the lock system, when the locks are there, suppose this is the water level, this is water level and this is another water level, and this is the canal, this is the land mass. This is one water body, this is the water level, and this is also the water level. Or you can say one side, this is the one lake, this is another lake. Though I am discussing the steel industry, but I wanted to let you know the lock system. So what happened, they have connected, they have constructed like canal, and when this, it is ships are coming over here, they have constructed a dam here. When this dam is filled with the water here, these ships may come up to here. Then they control it, and they have constructed another dam, and with the help of that dam, the ships are shifted over here, and then water is released. जब ship यहाँ आ जाएगा, तो पानी का level नीचे ले आते हैं, तो ship यहाँ आ जाएगा. और जब ship यहाँ आएगा, तो another lock is here. इस ship को यहाँ तक भर लेते हैं पानी को. पानी को यहाँ भर के यहाँ ले आते हैं. So ship comes here, the water level receded here. So this is like ship is here. Is height se ship, this is the height of the ship, raised here, 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 and ultimately it's construct the lake here, and they filled the water. Is pe bhi dam bana dete hai yaha, aur is paani ko aage le aate hai. This water is filled, so yaha aa jata hai, aur fir paani ko niche utar lete hai. The same ship comes here. वाटर लेवल चेंज होता जाता है, तो सी लेवल पे दीज आर दी डिफरेंट लॉक सिस्टम. फिर इसी तरह जो यहाँ पानी आ गया, यहाँ लाके पानी भर देते हैं, वो ऊपर उठ जाता है, फिर लाके पानी भर देते हैं, फिर वो यहाँ पानी भरा, इसको पानी भर दिया तो सिप यहाँ आ गया, फिर सिप यहाँ आया तो फिर इसको बंद करके फिर पानी भर दिया, यहाँ आ गया, यहाँ आने के बाद सिप को इधर ले आता. सो सिप कुड ट्रैवल फ्रॉम हाई वाटर level of water to the low level of water. This is called lock system. So this Welland Canal is working as a lock system between Lake Ontario and Lake Erie. It provides navigational facility. Kai bar students sochte honge ki sir Niagara waterfall pe ship kaise travel karenge? They travel like this. Because I have personally visited, traveled to this area. बल्कि यहाँ लॉक सिस्टम में तो जैसे आपके आप मेट्रो में एस्केलेटर पे चढ़ते हैं, एस्केलेटर पे जब जाते हैं तो आप दोनों हाथ से पकड़ लेते हैं ना, हाथ में हैंड बार्स आर देयर, हैंड बार्स भी रोटेट करते हैं. तो इसी तरह हैंड बार की जगह वहाँ मशीन्स होती हैं, और सिप को ऐसे बांध दिया जाता है और हैंड बार चलती है, सिप ऊपर की तरफ चला जाता है. So it's all, it is working at Welland Canal also. Here I wanted to let you know, this is one, this is two, this is three, and this is four. All this is, not this, these are the four important iron ore deposits of USA. The largest iron ore deposits of USA are just located south of Superior Lake that is called the Mesabi range. Meno meaning. Meno meaning. This is called Gogebic. कुछ और भी है छोटी छोटी माइंस, बट मेसाबी इज द लार्जेस्ट माइन. इट इज लोकेटेड हियर. देर इज अ पोर्ट कॉल्ड ड्यूलुथ, डी यू एल यू टी एच, एंड देर इज अनदर पोर्ट कॉल्ड सुपीरियर. यहाँ दो पोर्ट है, वन इज कॉल्ड ड्यूलुथ एंड वन इज कॉल्ड सुपीरियर. सो यहाँ विंटर में तो बल्कि बर्फ जम जाती है. जब भी सिप चलता है उसके आगे स्नो कटर लगाते हैं और वो उसका सिप का रास्ता बनाता जाता है. यहाँ से सिप आया, स्नो कटर यहाँ तक तो ठीक रहती है, यूरोप में बर्फ़ जमनी शुरू हो जाती है और यहाँ कटर लगा देते हैं और उसको बर्फ़ काटते जाते हैं. सारे एक लाइन में 10 के 10 सिप इधर आ जाते हैं, फिर वापस जाते हैं. जब यहाँ आते हैं तो कोयला लेके आते हैं. दे ब्रिंग द कोल फ्रॉम वेयर? दे ब्रिंग द कोल फ्रॉम कार्बन डेल दिस पेंसिल्वेनिया रीजन थ्रू दी कैनाल. दिस इज ए कैनाल. सेम सिप ड्रिंक्स द वाटर कोल फ्रॉम हियर एंड रीच टू दिस ड्यूलुथ. ड्यूलुथ इज द स्टील प्लांट. कहाँ से कोल आया? इट इज फ्रॉम द पेंसिल्वेनिया रीजन. दे हैव द लोकल आयरन ओर. वही सिप जब वापस जाएगा तो सेम सिप विल बी लोडेड विद द आयरन ओर बिकॉज मेसाबी, मेनोमिनी एंड गोगेबिक. दीज आर द आप देख लेना क्या है. सो जो सिप यहाँ आया कोयला लेके और जब वापस जाएगा इट विल कैरी दी आयरन ओर और आयरन ओर को इट विल सप्लाई दी आयरन ओर टू दिस रीजन. सो दिस इज द चीप नेविगेशनल फैसिलिटी provides to develop the easy access to construct the steel plant. Yahan Duluth is the largest steel plant of this area because Duluth is the port also. This is the port city which handle the transport to export the Mesabi range iron ore. Mesabi range was the largest range iron ore, iron producing region. But Mesabi lost its significance. The best quality of iron ore is completely exhausted and it is left with only siderite and limonite. Siderite is a poor quality of iron ore which is having metal content less than 40%. So economically it is not good, but since they have the inertia, they have the machines, they have the system, they have the port, still they are using the old poor quality of iron ore from Mesabi and Gogebic and Menomini. They are Menomini, N-double-E hai, Menomini. This area is having only Duluth is the important port. Apart from Duluth, there is the Superior is also the port. You know, there is a city called Milwaukee. Aapne Milwaukee suna hai? Milwaukee is one very super known for super specialized industries. Milwaukee, you know, Jaipur Foot, Dr. Sethi, Padam Siri, Dr. Sethi, who developed the Jaipur Foot for the physically challenged people, for making the artificial limbs. It is the basically that technology came from Milwaukee. Milwaukee is known for super specialized artificial limbs manufacturing in this region. So this is basically Milwaukee region. So iron ore, this region is producing. The Superior region is lake region as the industrialization because ore is there. So iron ore is there in the lake region. Name of the mines are here. Navigation is there. So it is less population density is there. Adverse climate is there, but because of mechanization it is there. Apart from that, there is another city here called Chicago. This is the industrialized town with supply, which is the largest market for the iron steel manufactured over here. Here we have a city called Detroit. You know Detroit? once it was known as the automobile capital of the world. So Detroit is very close to Chicago, Detroit and Milwaukee. All are accessible through navigation. Navigation से इधर चले जाओ, they all are, they provide the cheap navigational facility. This is one. Apart from this region, along this Erie region, along the Lake Erie, there is a city called Buffalo. Buffalo. Buffalo is there, and Cleveland, Detroit, and Erie. There is another city called Cleveland. Sorry, Buffalo is here. Buffalo and Cleveland. C-L-E-A-V-E. Cleveland. And if we say this region is also called the Pennsylvania region, in the Pittsburgh region, I would say number one, the center is the Pittsburgh.
Rust Bowl is the
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh, Rust Bowl of USA.
Yes. Pittsburgh, another city is Wheeling. And you know Akron. Akron is the city known for synthetic rubber. And Akron is here, very close to this Akron. Fiber products and synthetic rubber. This is known as Akron, Pittsburgh, Wheeling. There is another city. Yes, Erie. Erie is on Lake Erie. There is a city called Erie. जनरल मोटर का तो हेड ऑफिस यही है. देयर इस सिटी, इस लेक का भी नाम इरी इसलिए पड़ा क्योंकि यहाँ इरी इज द सिटी इज लोकेटेड. जनरल मोटर, जनरल इलेक्ट्रिकल्स, इतने बड़े व्हीकल्स हैं सब, वो सब इरी में ही है. सो इरी, पिट्सबर्ग, व्हीलिंग, रीडिंग, एक्रॉन, देयर इज अनदर सिटी कॉल्ड रीडिंग. रीडिंग, व्हीलिंग, एक्रॉन, इरी, Buffalo, Detroit, Chicago, all these cities are having steel units. Maybe small, maybe big, variety of steel plants are located. All they are, this is, I simply wanted to highlight the significance of the Great Lakes. Because of the cheap navigational facility, we have the industrialization. Steel industries are located over there. So, this is one apart from this. One more mine is there. I just came to know. This is Marquette. ये नाम नहीं बोलना बेटे. M-A-R-Q-U-E-T-T-E. Yes. Mesabi, Menomini, Gogebic, and Marquette. These are the four most important iron ore producing mines of USA. Like in India, we used to say. Kiriburu, Novamundi, Gua, Sulaipat, Guru Mahisani. So they are the largest mines of USA. So this is the lake region. What is the significance of lake? We have the steel plants are there. Because we have the heavy engineering industries manufacturing the engines, locomotives, aircrafts. They all are manufacturing the machines, arms, ammunitions, heavy agricultural implements, tractors, big machines, combined harvesters, agricultural implements. So this area is in large need, demand of the steel, and they are also exporting the steel because they have the cheap navigational transport facilities there. So this is one reason I discussed. This is the lake region. I hope you came to know the significance of lake because they are the navigable lakes. Apart from this, the second region is the this Pacific coastal region. I don't know, lock systems are clear to you or not, but lock systems are necessary to know. Second region is this is Atlantic coastal region. Atlantic coastal region. In this Atlantic coastal region is facing the Europe. They have the trade facility, they have the navigational facility, and they have the close proximity of coal field. They are just 300 kilometers far from the Pennsylvanian coal field. Pennsylvanian, the best quality of coal field are there. Navigation is there. Inland navigation, canal navigation is also available. So the most important industrial town is Philadelphia. ये तो वो सिटी है जहाँ वाशिंगटन से पहले यूएस की कैपिटल होती थी. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट बाल्टीमोर, देन स्पैरोज पॉइंट, देन व्हीलिंग एंड बेथलेहम. बेथलेहम वो वाला नहीं, इजराइल और पैलेस्टीन वाला बेथलेहम नहीं. दैट इज द रिलीजियस प्लेस. दिस इज द इंडस्ट्रियल टाउन. दिस इज स्टिल वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट स्टील मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्लांट ऑफ यूएसए. बेथलेहम, दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट टाउन्स इन क्लोज, दे आर लोकेटेड क्लोज टू वाशिंगटन एंड न्यूयॉर्क, द टू बिग इंडस्ट्रियल टाउन्स. So if I make, this is the USA, this is the Chesapeake Bay, and this is in USA, it is like this. Here we have the, this is the Appalachian Mountains. This side of Appalachian we have the good quality of coal, and these are the towns. This is Sparrow's Point, this is Philadelphia, this is Bethlehem, this is Wheeling. This is Appalachian Mountain. So this side of Appalachian, this is Atlantic Ocean. In Atlantic Ocean, we have the navigational facility. We import the raw material from the Africa and South America, and this is the navigational facility from the coal field. So this is the close proximity of coal field. This area also import iron ore from the Mesabi range. So through the navigational region, so iron ore from
Mesabi,
ore from Mesabi range. So these are the, this is basically very close to New York, and New York is one of the city which require huge amount of steel because of their industries. And this is one of the important fishing area of USA, because northeastern part of USA there is the immense potential to catch the fish. So यहाँ बहुत सारी मछली पकड़ते हैं, तो उनको बहुत सारी fish के लिए बहुत सारे boat चाहिए, steamer चाहिए, fishing boat चाहिए. So they need lot of steel for making those boats. So trawlers. So this, there is the large demand in this area, and here is the Virginia. Virginia is the headquarter of US Navy, world's most powerful navy, जिसको सबसे ज़्यादा warship बनाने हैं, जहाँ warship यहीं खड़े होते हैं. 1971 की लड़ाई हुई थी ना, US is having 7 naval fleets which are carrying the nuclear armaments on it. सात में से 4 तो अटलांटिक ओशन में डेब्यूट किए हुए हैं नाटो के सपोर्ट में, और 2 पैसिफिक ओशन में है, यूएस की बॉर्डर टच करता है. 6, 7वां अननेसेसरीली इंडियन ओशन में डेब्यूट किया हुआ है, डिएगो गार्सिया में. डिएगो गार्सिया इज वन आइलैंड जस्ट साउथ ऑफ इक्वेटर, 4 डिग्री साउथ ऑफ इक्वेटर डिएगो गार्सिया इज देयर. अब जब 71 की वार हुई, दैट सेवेंथ नंबर फ्लीट, सातवां बेड़ा, इट वाज over there in Virginia for repair.